All right, Tennessee Valley, come on and say amen. You're listening to WDJL 1000 AM, the Dream of Change, where Jesus is our joy. Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning, faithful.
How you doing?
Well, it is a terrific Tuesday morning, a great day to be alive in the Lord and sharing the good news.
You're right. Well, I know you got some news that we can use, so I'm going to sit back and receive this powerful word from God for Pastor Mark Barrows with Christ in Action. Take it away, Pastor.
All right, indeed. Delighted to be sharing good news this morning. And, of course, the good news is heavenly news. It's not just news about going to heaven one day, but it's about the one who came all the way from heaven down, as they would say when I was growing up, to represent our case and cause, and to do so perfectly, be delivered up for your and my offenses and raised again for our justification. It is ultimately what is our basis of confidence towards God and his goodness to be shown in our life every day. The simplicity of the gospel, the Apostle Paul described it as the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes it, who receives the message. It is truth. It's not a fairy tale. It is truth. But when we accept it as truth for our own lives, we embrace and we see the good news of God as it is given unto us in Christ for all time and eternity, because he is the difference maker for our lives. Well, friend, talking about being a difference maker is all the month of October. We're talking about community. And the other day, as we were teaching on this, I asked everybody to write down the word community, to spell it out, C-O-M-M-U-N-I-T-Y. And what we find is that the center letter of community is you. You are the heart of community. You, me, every single one of us. That's why we always talking about that we are the difference that makes the difference that God intends, we design, the world needs. It's so important for us to see that. As they say often, it's an amazing thing to begin to see and know the greatness of God and to worship and honor him for that greatness. But when it translates to us to understanding the greatness of his investment in us, it begins to make a whole difference in our house, in our relationships, in our community, in our marriages, and wherever we find ourselves, because we begin to realize that God has made it such that the things that he will do in this earth, he will do it through us. You know, someone wrote a song many years ago, a pastor wrote a song saying, Lord, whatever you do, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. Well, the way for us to be certain of that is, first of all, to know that what God is doing in this world, he wants and will do through us. Philippians chapter 2, verse 13, you hear me quote this often, says, it is God who works in you, in me, in us, both to will and to do of his good pleasure. When we pray for God to work, what we're really praying for is that God will work in and through us. When we pray his will be done on earth as it is in heaven, what we need to do and what we should be doing is embracing and bracing ourselves for what he will begin to do through us. I call it action praying. It's important to pray, but then it's important to act on the heels of that prayer, because God will begin the solution and answer to whatever we pray in us. Now, it will not just end with us. It will spread to others, but it always begins with you, with me, with us. And so we must see this, embrace it. And when we do, you know, it's not that we're seeing ourselves as, you know, God can't do anything without me. No, he chooses to do what he does in and through us. What a privilege, what an honor that we should be called the temple of God, the place where God lives and moves. has his being and expresses himself and does his will in the earth. Friend, do you see life that way? Do you see yourself that way? And do you see others that way? See, that's so key for us. First of all, to know God works in me. He lives and works in me. And that he works and works in every one of us. So then we open ourselves up to cherish and to value and see one another, knowing that God will work through our lives in the lives of those we meet. But God will also work in our lives through the people that we meet. And then when we all have this attitude and perspective, good God Almighty, God just working all over the place through me, you, through you, through them, through us, through all of us together. And you know what? I believe that's why it says in the last days, God will do a quick work and finish it in righteousness, because we will exalt him and his greatness, but we'll also celebrate the greatness of God in us and others. And together, we will see God's purposes and the glory of this latter house that he has promised, that was greater than the former, to be fulfilled and come to fruition as we see his power working in and through us. But you know what? You got to see it. It's bigger than me. It is about me, but it's bigger than me. It's about us all together in Jesus' name. Well, this has been an outreach of Connected Church. Connect with us, connected-church.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, wherever we can get the word out. Of course, right here every day on this Gospel Explosion outreach to the Tennessee Valley and beyond. This is what you'll find. The word of God is declared. God is uplifted. His love for you. Declare that your faith might rest in him, his love for you, your identity that you have in him, that we are together the difference that makes the difference that God intends, that we desire and the world needs. As we awaken his purpose of knowing him and his love for us, mobilize his mission of making him known and sharing his love with others. That's good news on this terrific Tuesday, Faithful.
Absolutely right. News that everybody can use to help us throughout the day. And thank you for that powerful word this morning. For God is love, and we are to be loved.
Yes, ma'am. That's it right there. And so, hey, we appreciate what you do every single day for us all day long. And Lord willing, we'll talk to you again real soon. Bye-bye.
All right. Have a wonderful day.
You too now.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, go in the strength and ability of God, knowing God's greatness in you, looking for that greatness in others as he makes the difference in and through us today. Have a great day today. We'll talk to you again real soon. Okay, bye-bye.